A special pardon is granted by South Korea's president to one of his predecessors, Lee Myung-bak. President Yoon Suk-yeol's move will allow Lee to be released from his 17-year prison sentence for bribery and embezzlement. Yoon granted special pardons to some 1,300 inmates on Tuesday, including the 81-year-old Lee, who has been serving his prison term since October 2020. Lee, who was South Korea's chief executive from 2008 to 2013, is the fourth former president to be issued a pardon since the country's transition to full democracy in 1987. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky seeks India's help for a so-called peace formula with Russia. He spoke with Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi in a phone call Monday. The development comes as New Delhi seeks to boost trade relations with Moscow after becoming one of the largest purchasers of Russian oil. Putin has said he's ready to negotiate acceptable solutions regarding Moscow's war in Ukraine. But this has failed to convince Zelensky, who says Putin is only avoiding responsibility as Russia continues to target Ukrainian civilians. Again in Japan, where border restrictions will be tightened for travelers coming from China. Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida announced the new measures Tuesday as Beijing grapples with a mass COVID outbreak. He says beginning December 30th, travelers from mainland China will be required to present a negative COVID test upon arrival to Japan. Those who test positive will also need to quarantine for 7 days. Kishida adds the government will seek to limit Japanese airlines' requests to increase flights to China. Tokyo previously reopened its borders to tourists in October. That's after more than 2 years of strict COVID restrictions. Now, despite soaring infections, China's further easing its COVID-19 policy. Authorities announced quarantine requirements for arriving foreign passengers will be scrapped starting January 8th. This marks a major step for China towards reopening travel with the world after nearly 3 years of strict border controls. But arriving passengers still need to present a negative COVID test 48 hours before departure. Meanwhile, hospitals in Beijing stretched thin amid an influx of patients. Authorities have put up so-called fever clinics to help ease the pressure on medical facilities. A correspondent of the state-run CGTN says fever clinics are catering up to 250 patients per day. That's lower than the peak of 500 per day, but still higher than usual.
Hospitals in Beijing are still operating under, of course, a lot of pressure, with reports of doctors and nurses having to stay on their shifts even after contracting COVID themselves. Influx of patients is still stretching thin vital medical resources. Hospitals now need to find ways to expand their intensive care units and add more beds. And at the same time, most hospitals in the city say they have opened fast-track admissions for other emergency cases like strokes and special care persons like pregnant women.
The unprecedented surge in infections, however, has not deterred other residents from going out and experiencing a semblance of normalcy after nearly 3 years.
Residents who are taking advantage of the cancellation of much of the social restrictions. For example, I checked on one of the major shopping areas in Beijing last night. It was Christmas night. While China does not celebrate Christmas, this holiday has usually been a day when people just go out for shopping and some family fun. Since the area I visited no longer has COVID negative requirements and health QR code to scan, there were substantially more people than the same periods in the last 2 years, as far as I can tell. Now, shops were crowded, restaurants were full, vendors were out in droves. So no doubt, many residents are seizing the opportunity to try to bring back their pre-pandemic lifestyles.